Hello everybody and welcome back to another tutorial on Flutter. The goal today is to implement the pull to refresh feature with Flutter's inbuilt widgets. To do that, we'll be using two of the widgets, Refresh Indicator, which renders material style design, and CupertinoSliverRefreshControl, which renders iOS style design. With that said, let's jump right in. As the name suggests, we pull from the top and keep going until an event is triggered. We can also trigger this pulling at the bottom of the list or from the right or left when using a horizontal list. The top level trigger is the most popular and we will only implement that in the tutorial today. The other types cannot be achieved with the inbuilt widgets as of the date of creation of this video. We will have to use the Flutter packages in order to implement them. Now that these parts have been discussed, let's see how this can be accomplished. You can either create a new Flutter project using the Flutter create command or download the repository from the link given in the description section below. Once that is done, open the project in Android Studio or any other IDE that you prefer. Create a Dart file inside a pull to refresh package and name it pull to refresh example. Create a widget with the same name and import the necessary packages. Let's add an app bar to this by using a scaffold widget. Now in the main file, remove all these boilerplate codes and add our new widget. To remove the debug banner, set the debug show checked mode banner property to false and change the primary swatch to a bluish hue. Create another class Android Indicator Example and add it to the pull to refresh example widget. In this class, we will use the refresh indicator widget to implement the material style pull to refresh functionality. It has two mandatory attributes, child and onRefresh. It is possible to pass any widget to the child property, but it will not work unless there is at least one scrollable widget in its hierarchy, such as a list view. The onRefresh property requires a function that returns a future. When we pull enough distance from the top of the list, this onRefresh function will be triggered. The default threshold distance is set to 40 pixels, but we can change this by passing the displacement property. Let's run this in an iOS simulator. Here the functionality is not working because the children do not have any widgets that can scroll. Wrap the children with a list view widget. When we pull enough distance, onRefresh is triggered and it goes into the loading state, which can be seen by this loading indicator. Here the loading indicator disappears as soon as we leave the mouse because we are yet to pass some value to the future here. In the practical scenario, the API call is made here to fetch the new data which is appended to the list. Let's wait for the future of few seconds so that we can see the loading state properly. In the loading state, the pull to refresh is disabled. This state is completed when the future completes and then the pull to refresh could be triggered again to fetch the new data, if any. In the documentation, there is one troubleshooting problem that developers often face, that is, the refresh indicator does not show up. It reads as, the refresh indicator will appear if its scrollable descendant can be overscrolled. That is, if the scrollable's content is bigger than its viewport. To ensure that the refresh indicator will always appear, even if the scrollable's content fits within its viewport, set the scrollable's physics property to always scrollable scroll physics. In our example, the refresh indicator should only show up when the scrollable content, that is, list view in our case, is bigger than the viewport. Here the indicator is showing up even if the list view is not bigger than the viewport. It's because the physics is set to always scrollable scroll physics in the list view. if we firstly change the property to make the physics value null, or just change the physics value to some other value except always scrollable scroll physics, then the indicator will not show up. In this case, the size of the list view must be large enough such that the content becomes scrollable. That is, its size is greater than the viewport. There are other properties of this widget that we can use. Background color and color can be used to change the background and the color of the loading indicator. Stroke width can be used to update the stroke width of the loading indicator. We can use the edge offset property to set the distance from where the loading indicator will show up. Its default value is set to 0. Notification predicate can be used for the scenario when we have nested scroll views. Let's say we have two scroll views as the child of the refresh indicator. The indicator will be triggered by both of the scrolling widgets. Both of these list views have a depth of 0. The depth will be increased if there are nested scroll views, that is, scroll views inside other scroll views. If we have nested scroll views down the tree, then the triggering could be delegated to the child scroll views. The notification predicate is set to trigger for the scroll views with a depth of 0. The top scroll view has 0 depth, their child depth would be 1, and so on. Hence, if we update the predicate to match with the scroll views of depth 1, then the indicators will be triggered by the child scroll views and cannot be triggered by the parent. Pull to refresh will be disabled if we return false here, while if we pass true, pull to refresh will trigger for all scroll views in the hierarchy. With all these information, let's build a pull to refresh functionality that fetches the data, if any, and appends it to the current list of items. I have this MockUtils class, which has a function that gives a list of random items. Next, I have this card widget, which has a design of the image on the left and some text on the right. You can get these files from the link in the description section below. Place these files in the utils and widget packages inside the lib package. We'll display the list given by the MockUtil class using the design given by the simple card widget with the pull to refresh functionality. The basic idea is to use the pull to refresh to fetch the data and add it to the list. We'll mock the API call here, where we can replace the actual API call later when required. First of all, convert this stateless widget to stateful, since we need a state variable to store the list of items. Then store the list of items in a state variable. Next, use a list view builder widget to render the list of items to the view. Also, let's mock the API call in the refresh function. For that, we'll pick a random element from the given list and append it to the list. Our work on the pull to refresh has been finished using the refresh indicator widget. And in the next section, we'll explore CupertinoSliverRefreshControl widget, which renders an iOS style indicator. As a sliver widget, it should be used with widgets that can hold render sliver, such as custom scroll view widget. It also has onRefresh property, similar to the one we used before, that must return a future. As with the refresh indicator widget's displacement property, refresh trigger pull distance is the distance the list should be dragged in order to trigger the onRefresh function. Refresh indicator extent property indicates how far the loading indicator settles from the top of the list after the onRefresh function has been called. This value should not be greater than the refresh trigger pull distance. We also have the option to change the loading indicator by passing a different value to the builder property, but we'll not look into that in this section. Make a copy of Android indicator example and name it iOS indicator example. Let's make some changes here to replace the refresh indicator widget with Cupertino Sliver Refresh Control. Firstly, comment on these and return a custom scroll view widget from the build function. It must have a list of slivers, one of which will be Cupertino Sliver Refresh Control. Pass the refresh function that we have here to the onRefresh property. Now add a sliver list to render the list of items here. It takes a delegate, and for that use sliver child builder delegate, which works similarly to the list view builder widget. Pass the builder function as before and give the children count as well. We now have pull to refresh functionality ready with iOS style loading indicator. To disable the pull to refresh using this way, we can simply render this widget conditionally. We have looked into two ways that we can use to implement pull to refresh without any third party packages. Depending on our preference, we can choose any of them. As we can see, the Android style indicator will be displayed for both iOS and Android devices when we use the Refresh Indicator class, whereas the Cupertino Sliver Refresh Control widget renders iOS style pull to refresh. But what if we need both, depending on which device we run the app on? That is, there needs to be an iOS style indicator for iOS devices and an Android style indicator for Android devices. For that, create another class, Platform Indicator List View. Create a stateless widget that has attributes for the count, item builder, and on refresh. Using the platform class in the Dart.io package, we can determine whether the device is Android or iOS or any other platform. Check the conditions for iOS to use the custom scroll view widget. Then add the Cupertino Sliver Refresh Control widget and Sliver List as in the previous example. Add the Refresh Control widget and then the List View Builder widget as we did before for everything else except iOS. Finally, let's create a copy of any of the examples and call it Platform Pull to Refresh Example. In this widget, we simply need to replace the list view with the Platform Indicator List View widget and remove the Refresh Indicator class. Now, if we run this, we'll see two different types of pull to refresh. The loading indicator on iOS device appears in iOS style, while on Android, it appears in material style. This concludes our tutorial. We implemented a minimal pull to refresh feature, which you are welcome to change as per your needs. Please do leave your thoughts in the comments section below. And also do not forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you and have a wonderful day.